Hello and welcome to another Scriptcase Fundamentals training. During this class, you will learn about the different types of fields which are available within the form application. Each of the available fields has a different purpose and can be useful in various situations. But before I begin, it is important to note that the form application is tied to the database, meaning that it is not possible to create a form application without any database fields. The reason for this is that the initial form fields are tied to the table selected, so that when I create my database table and then my form, the tables and fields are correctly identified. Let's start by taking a look at our database values. The reason why I'm going to do this is because when I create fields inside the database, I also need to define the data type, which is then also related to the field purpose. If the stored value is to be numbers, integer or general characters being varchar, date or images, and selecting the correct values within the database will then provide them to Scriptcase, which will use that information for the field creation within the various applications. For instance, when I create a form inside of Scriptcase, the application will recognize the database field types. And it will set those definitions for the applications you create, including the typical validations for the various fields available. Even for the basic fields, which you manually create, you are able to use native field types from within Scriptcase, such as file and image type, or Google Maps, currency, and even a signature field type. Field types from applications include integrated functions that will help you to build your field validations much faster. So when you select a file as the file type, it will automatically provide the correct validation and provide you with relevant fields for the configuration. Let's now check out some of the available options that are presented, as well as each of the available field types. So let's check out each of the available field types within Scriptcase. So within my form, I am then able to select the option fields within the tab form setting. And here I have each of my fields available. And within each of the fields, I am able to configure or specify settings for each individual field. Now notice that when I change the field type, the settings below will change. Let's now check out some of the available options that are presented, as well as each of the available field types. Let's start with the standard text field. So here I have my product name, and this is already a text field. So to display and insert text into the database, we have this text field, as well as then the multiple lines text as our main options. The difference between these two fields are the type of displayed component that is used within the form. One is a standard input field. So now if I run this and then edit my product, I can see I now have a text field. The alternative is then the multiple lines text. And run that again, we will then be able to immediately see the difference between the two fields. Now I have multiple lines. The text area allows for further text visibility and entry within your form. Another alternative for text is also the HTML editor, which is available under the special, and there we have the HTML editor. The HTML editor is an advanced WYSIWYG HTML editor that provides a fully featured rich text editing experience. It's a really interesting component which you can edit using the native tools within Scriptcase. It also has the ability to convert HTML text area fields or other HTML elements to editor instances. So running the form again, we can then see the difference between the text area as well as then the HTML editor. Now the HTML editor can also be applied with templates, which are available within Scriptcase, and you can also edit and create your own. With a flip of the switch, we can also display HTML content if we so choose. Now to insert and display numbers, we have the integer type within our database. As well as here within Scriptcase, we have integer, decimal, as well as the currency fields available. So I can highlight the currency field and select that, and then I can define the currency symbol that I want to have displayed within my application and that is going to be used, which is depending on the localization of the project. So here we can apply regional settings, digit grouping, as well as to display the currency symbol in use, and also the option to display a calculator, as well as a standard or scientific option. We then also have the date, time, and date time field. These are used to keep the display date and time information. The date and time format are defined by the localization again, which you configure within your project and applications. However, you can define custom date and time formats. There are also special fields that are used in specific cases where we need creative solutions, such as the HTML image. For instance, this is a field type where you can add images using the Scriptcase image management tool. Or the label field that is used to only display data that cannot be edited by the end user. We also have the credit card number and credit card fields that are used to define the correct validation and check the provided credit card information or numbers. There is also the typical email field, URL field that is used to insert complete website URLs, and the email field to catalog email addresses. For the URL field, we have further options which allow us to provide a clickable link, as well as to display an icon if we so choose. Other fields include the localization field, the theme field, the localization field. This field is used to change the language of the whole page as well as the provided regional settings. This field can be very useful when used in multi-language systems, allowing users to switch from one language to another. The theme field is used to change the whole application theme. So we can include multiple themes as we had seen during the project creation and then give users the option to change the theme of the template as they are using the application. The YouTube field that is available can be used to insert or store a YouTube video URL into the database. Beside the input, you can have a button that redirects to the provided URL and the YouTube video. You can also display if you want to have the video displayed in a modal window or within a new window. Google Maps is another field available which is used to display locations stored in the database. Using a Google Maps frame, there is also everything provided for Google Maps API integration. Within the database tables or elsewhere, you only need to store or define the longitude and latitude, as well as provide an API key for the Google account. The signature field type records signatures from a user, and it does this using images that are automatically created and stored in the database. If you want to create a rating system within your project, you may want to use the rating field, which is used to store data and display it as symbols, which can also be modified to your own preference. The image and document or database and file name fields are used to store images or documents in the database. They can also optionally be used to store the data or files within a directory, and then store the file path in the database, which can be defined with a path or variable. The barcode field type is another interesting option available. It provides you with different types of barcode codifications. It can be really useful when creating product inventories, invoices, or receipts. The barcode used within your application can be fully configured within the options. The select and double select, checkbox, and radio field types are each different components, each of which include a manual option and also an optional lookup feature for the database. This can be used for the selection or insert of data. The text, autocomplete, and number autocomplete fields allow for easy database lookup. Using these field types, you can auto-suggest content to the end user while they are entering their data using the available data within your database. Thank you for watching this part of the Scriptcase Fundamentals training. I hope to see you again soon in the next class.